Today, our guest on Let's Talk Jonesboro is Brandi Hodges from the library, Jonesboro, Craighead County Library. And Brandi has some exciting news for us about checkout options and quite a few other things, right, Brandi?
Of course I do. We always have something fun going on at the library. In the last month, we have actually installed a new way for you to check out. Normally, the way you would check out books is you go to our children's library desk or you go to the circulation desk and you place your items in front of whoever's working and you ask to check them out. Now, you can still do that. And no jobs or anyone is being affected. In fact, we always have work that needs to be done at the library. But now, you can check yourself out.
That is, I do that at my grocery store.
Right, and you can do
it. Took a little while to get confident doing it, but I can do it with my books now.
You can. So
or DVDs or whatever exactly you want to check out.
The way it works is you take a stack, and it only can fit so many, but however long the distance is from the top of the scanner to where you set them down, as long as you can fit it underneath, it will check everything out at the same time.
At once.
At one time.
That's fabulous.
You can check out your DVDs. It will prompt you to unlock your DVD. It'll say, unlock your DVD, and you stick it in the side of the machine, and it will unlock it. So unless there's something going on with the machine or if you have a problem, you can pay your fines at the machine. You can check out multiple different people. You can check the status of your account all right there at the machine.
That is fabulous.
We're just trying to make things easier on people. Not everyone has time to
right.
stand in line. We are so busy around 3 o'clock. When children get out of school, we're closing at 7 o'clock these days. A few years ago, we changed our hours to accommodate people better. So we get really busy from that 3 to 7 time period. And so that's when a lot of folks can really stop by and check out materials. If you work all day and you go and eat lunch on your hour lunch break, you have just that time after work to stop by the library and check out physical materials. And so sometimes people, they don't have time to wait in line. That's why a lot of times we use those self-checkout lanes at the grocery store, because it's a faster process.
Right.
We wanted to do everything we can to make it easy, to make the library a place where people want to come and spend some of their time.
Our lives are busier than ever, and it's a good thing because we've got so much technology to help us, and we're not having to ride the old mule up to the library, but we haven't thought of all the things the library can do. And in fact, and I don't hear it much lately, but there was a period where I heard from people, I don't want to use a derogatory term, but people who were misinformed had the theory that libraries were becoming irrelevant.
I have heard that so much. I've been at the library for nearly 7 years, and that's one of the first questions that people would ask me is, well, hey, when are you guys going to close your doors? Or how long is the library going to stay something that people want to use? And people don't really ask me that question as many times as they used to, because we try to prove that we're relevant. We have access to ebooks. We've had it for a long time. But something else new that we have that I haven't shared with you guys yet is a new resource. Before, we have had Overdrive, also known as Libby. Overdrive is the company. Libby is the app that you can use to download ebooks. But those are really, the books that we have are for teens and older. We didn't really have anything for kids.
Exactly.
And so just recently, in the last several months, we have added a new database to our library. It's called Access 360. And it is a audiobook source, ebook source, just for those up to 12 years old. You know, anyone can check it out. I enjoy a good children's book. I'm a big fan. I always have been. And so anyone can actually check these books out and read them. There are audiobooks and ebooks, so you can read it or you can listen to it. But what's special about this collection is not only are we offering it to the general population who has a library card, but we have partnered with some of the local schools. Our plan is to expand to all of the schools in our area that we cover. Craighead and Poinsett County are our coverage areas. We're slowly moving through the Craighead County, the Jonesboro schools. We started with the Nettleton schools. We started with the schools over, I'm not going to remember names right now. The University Heights schools are the schools that we started with. We've moved on to the Fox Meadow Elementary schools. And what it is, the library has a back door, if you will, mm-hmm. where we provide, you can check out 7 to 14 days is your checkout time. What we're doing is we're partnering with the schools where we give them backdoor access too. The children can check out with their school ID number to check out the books. And the teachers say they want to give the second graders more time to have that book. They can do that. But the same copy that is available for me and you is available mm-hmm. to the children. So if a child checks that book out, they'll have it for a while. If I check that book out, I have it for my checkout period. It's the same collection. It's anything we can do to make access to the library easier is something we are trying to accomplish.
Now let me ask you this. You talk about the ebooks, and is there an app or that I need for my iPad, my Kindle, my whatever?
There is. So if you'll go to our website, our library website is libraryinjonesboro.org. There's a tab at the top of our page that says eMedia. If you will click on that, there will be a full page that explains everything to you. The app for Access 360, you can search it in your app store. It's called Access AXIS 360. The app to download books through OverDrive is called Libby. There is many people still have the OverDrive app on their devices. The OverDrive app can still be used. However, the company is no longer updating that app. They've developed a new app called Libby. And so we're encouraging everyone to delete your old OverDrive app and switch to Libby. It's easy. It's free to download. You can still use that OverDrive app, but at some point, many things on it will no longer work.
Now, if I don't have a library card, I still need to go to the library to fill out the forms and get it, right?
You can. We will be at different locations throughout the year where we'll have mobile libraries set up.
Drives.
But those aren't Alive After Five with Downtown Jonesboro Association. We're there every month, and we do library card signups at that event. We're at different events doing that. But if you want to get a library card and you need to get a library card, it's free to do. All you have is a photo ID, like a driver's license, as long as it has your current mailing address on it.
Right.
If it doesn't have your current mailing address, we just need a piece of mail, just something that shows that you live in our coverage area. Because in order to qualify for a library card, you have to live in Craighead or Poinsett counties.
Well, and if you don't have a library card or you feel like it's obsolete, I encourage you to go get one and find out what all you're missing, because it's incredible. You're not just about books on aisle that are organized in ways that only librarians can find
them. Dewey Decimal System.
Dewey!
That's all of our nonfiction collection is by the Dewey Decimal System. Our fiction collection and all the other collections are just alphabetical, so it's easier to find. I do want to point out, you brought it up, so I'm running with it. We're not obsolete. We're not just books.
That's right.
Even if we were just books, we still have a lot
to
offer.
We'd still be valuable.
But
right.
Some of the things that we do, summer is coming up. We're not very far away from it at all. And the primary part about summer are the events that we have. So you don't have to have a library card. You don't even have to live in this area. We'll have people passing through who will see, oh, you've got a concert outside. I want to attend that.
Yes.
So I like to point out that if you don't have a library card, if you're not interested in getting a library card, but you want to come to yoga on, you know, Tuesdays, or you want to come to Zumba on Thursdays, you can come to it without having to sign up to get a library card.
A good library is a gathering spot, a community get-together spot.
Exactly. We like to think of ourselves as sort of like a community center. We offer free exercise classes. We have monthly book clubs. In addition to that, in June, every Tuesday night, we'll have a free concert on the front lawn. We always book local bands to play. Andy's Frozen Custard and Nuke's Eatery are sponsors. They'll bring free product out.
Oh my.
This summer, the theme is Libraries Rock. And so kids who come to the concerts will get a free cup that changes color when they put a drink in it. We'll have Tuesday's Rock and Thursday's Roll with our kids department. The t-shirt this summer has our library hedgehog, Ida, on the front of it. And it says, Ida Rocks. And every child who signs up and completes the program has the opportunity to be one of the 350 who finishes the program and get a free t-shirt. So There are so many opportunities at the library. You can see our full summer calendar on our website, libraryinjonesboro.org. We're actually mailing the calendar out this year. So the week of May 21st, watch for that calendar in your mailbox. So I just don't want people to throw it away. It's blue. It says summer on the front. We've tried different ways of distributing it before. This is the first time we're going to be mailing it out.
And obviously with kids out of school, you've got a lot of plans for kids.
Daily.
What age group do you see most often, and which age group are you trying to reach that you don't reach as much?
We want everyone to come. Mm-hmm. We don't want someone to think, oh, well, they see a bunch of kids of that age, so we don't need to go. Kids are the group we usually see most of, but we could always use more. We have plenty of room, plenty of space. Every Wednesday we have off-site programs because we know not everyone can come to the library. Not everyone wants to come to the library. So we do programs at the Parker Park Community Center every Wednesday at 10 and every Wednesday at 2 at the Mall at Turtle Creek. So those are some programs that we offer for kids. But an age group that we're really trying to reach are those that are about 18 to 35. Oh. It's that age group of those that have children come to the library, but a lot of those who have children don't. And, you know, if you're in that, your 20s, you know, you're not having to go to the library in college, having to do research. Right. And a lot of folks, that's our drop-off time.
That's interesting.
They'll stay with the library, you know, a lot. If you have come to the library, you'll stay through your childhood and through your teens. We see them drop off in the teens as well. So if you have a teenager, we are doing a masquerade ball for the teens. We're going to do lots of henna tattoo days. They're going to have a drum circle event. Lots of things going on for the teens. All of the events are posted on our Facebook page where you can click that you're interested or that you're going and let us know that you're attending, and you get those reminders.
Very nice. Now, and henna tattoos, that is an Indian concept. That is it. Are you talking about for the hands?
Yeah, we do temporary plant-based tattoos. We will have patterns laid aside. For the first time in our summer history, we're actually doing a henna for adults day. We always have adults come to our teen event, and our teen events are only for those who are 13 to 17. And we always have adults want to attend those events, and we'll have to say, I'm so sorry, are you 17? You know, and we like to make those events just for our teens because I know we're adults, and to be honest, we're just not as fun as the teens are, you know? And so teens won't want to attend events if adults are there as well a lot of times. And so we make those just for our teens.
Can't say it the way they want to say it.
But for adults, we're offering a painting class where we have an instructor come in and show you how to do it. We're going to have a Learn the Ukulele class.
Oh my.
Lots of fun things. Coming up on June 2nd from 10 until 2, we're going to have a huge kickoff party on our front lawn. More media is coming to do a live remote. We're going to have lots of fun events going on. We're going to paint rocks. We're going to help you sign up for summer reading club. Lots of fun things going on that day. So we hope that people will come out and join us. Everything we do is free, so there aren't any excuses.
There are no excuses, and you're funded through a little bit of grant money, and you're funded through donations.
We're funded the city and the county. We get tax money.
But
as well.
How can people give to the library?
Anyone who ever wants to make a donation to the library can do so. And if you would like to dedicate those funds to, I would like to help with the t-shirt program, or I would like to help with the summer concert series, because we do pay our bands to come and play at our summer concert series. Like I said, those are every Tuesday night in June at 6:30. So we have those bands booked already, but you know, we are a not-for-profit organization. So anytime anyone wanted to make a donation, we often will have people make donations in the name of someone.
That's nice.
So there are lots of ways that you can be involved.
Memorials and tributes.
Exactly. Yeah. But any information you ever would like to know at the library, you can call 870-935-5133 and speak to one of our librarians. Free classes for all ages. Right now is a slower time until we hit June. Once June and July pick up at the library, that is when our numbers sometimes not only double, sometimes they can triple from our normal, regular numbers. And, you know, we're not an empty place any time of the year. So we stay pretty busy, but we can always be busier.
Well, just as a refresher, we've talked about the things that you can do with computers. You're checking yourself out, and you have access to internet and all these sorts of things. What types of things, refresh people on what types of things that aren't traditional that the actual librarians can help you with?
So we have our librarians who work in our information services department. Mm-hmm. If you have questions, they have answers. We like to say that we're the original Google because, our librarians, this is what they're trained for.
Right.
Our children's librarians are wonderful storytellers. We all the time have folks say, well, I want to come read a story to the children at the library. We actually only allow our children's librarian staff to do that because that's what they're trained to do. That's for many of them, that's what they went to school for.
Right.
And so there are so many things that the librarians there can help you do. If you are writing a research paper and you need help doing that, if you want to get started in genealogy research, we have a vast genealogy collection in the back. You can actually access Jonesboro's Sun obituaries to 1896.
Oh my.
So it's a link on their website, but we included.
There was a Jonesboro Sun in 1896?
You can access those obituary records. You can also come and look at newspapers on our microfilm machines that we have, which are, doesn't sound like fun, but they're really kind of fun to use because you just put it under there and you just slide it really quickly. So there are lots of fun things you can do. I say fun because everyone's definition of fun is different. Those men and women who are doing the genealogy research, they get into it. We have an event coming up on July 21st from 6 until midnight. Everyone who stays until midnight will get a free t-shirt. Every t-shirt every year is different, but it's all about genealogy research. And we'll have a guest speaker come. Over the past several years, we've had guest speakers talk about the different DNA tests that you can take to find out your heritage. We had someone come and talk about how to trace your Native American heritage. We always have someone come and talk about something that people are talking about, something that is a hot topic in the genealogy world.
That's cool. That's cool. And recently we were in the little round room and you had a historian talking about some of the historic neighborhoods and homes and buildings in Jonesboro.
There's a lot of history
here. You just never know. There is.
You don't. Another thing I always like to remind people of is we do have a bookshop at the library. We have the Friends of the Library have a bookshop in the back of the building right next to our genealogy collection, and it is made up of books that are discards from the library collection and donations. That's another way people can donate. Say you don't want to or you're not able to donate monetarily, but you have children's books from when your children were small, or you have, books that you bought that you read one time and you're not ever going to read that book again. We also will get the Encyclopedia Britannica donated every now and then. So, there's a bookshop back in the back of the building where you can donate books. Everything that's in that collection is something that someone has donated or that was a discard from our library collection. So, and we will give you, of course, a tax receipt, so you can take that off of your taxes in the next year.
I need that.
See, you need to bring your books to us.
I do.
And we're going to be having a big sale the first weekend in June for the bookshop. Lots of different things. If you haven't checked the library out recently, it's something that you should probably do.
Go check it. Run the aisles like you do at Walmart and check out what all
we
is going to
really,
surprise you.
We don't allow running, but,
Okay.
Walk quickly.
Right. Roll through the aisles at a steady gait,
the
speed limit. Thank you, Brandi, so much. Is there anything else that we need to know about?
Always go to our website, libraryinjonesboro.org, to check out the events and activities we have going on. We will have a new way of signing up for Summer Reading Club this year. It's called Beanstack. And so that's what June 2nd partially is all about, is explaining Beanstack to people. I will have some information on our website as well. But when you go to sign up, every sign up for kids and teens will be done online this year through Beanstack. And it's just a different way of tracking your activities. Instead of having a piece of paper like has been done in the past, you'll earn badges and you'll earn prizes all online.
That's fabulous. You are wonderful, and thank you for taking the time to visit with us on Let's Talk Jonesboro.
Thank you for having me.